Howdy everybody, this is Bake with IronThroneCraft.com, and this is part two of our invasion on Kingdom 18. So we got a couple more rallies, some more solos, and everything else like that. If you haven't seen part one yet, the link is in the comments, so go check it out. We rally the king, who's 10 billion, rally a 7.5 billion, who eats us up pretty good. And in this one, we're going to get a little bit more into the mechanics of some of these hits, because some of these hits display the combat mechanics very well and let us know why and how we are winning. So right off the bat, you see that this guy is sitting right next to somebody that's holding a sanctuary, and his shield is down, and he's got troops. So hit him, one-shot him, 5.5 million kills, 2.5 million hospitalized. But here's the important part. If you look at it, I saw I got a lot of resources on that hit, so I scout him. And then I see my other teammates zeroing that guy over there. So I scout, 2.1 billion resources. So obviously I'm going to link that to Alliance chat. Let everybody know that there are resources here, and they're all going to descend upon this poor guy like a pack of dogs and loot it pretty quickly. So switch all my heroes over to Siege and go to town looting him. And he gets drained pretty quickly because C2 come to get you and Dizzle both have quite a bit of higher tier Siege. So we end up draining that 2 billion resources in about 30 seconds or so, maybe a little bit longer. I sped the video up quite a bit because it's pretty boring to watch me send Siege at somebody over and over and over again. And this is somebody asking me in Kingdom Chat if I will hit them with Tier 2 if they drop their shield. And I'm letting them know that even if I say I'll hit with Tier 2, my buddies will not. And that's just not going to happen. So if you do want points whenever you come invade your kingdom, sometimes I got time to do it, sometimes I don't, let me know and we'll do some tile hits. Otherwise, if you drop your shield, you're probably going to get hit. That's just how it is. So this guy goes empty. And then you see this person right here ported it in directly underneath me, this SSG guy. And he poured it in with me, C2, and Dizzle all in the same spot. And then he scouted me, which is sometimes not the best idea. I immediately tried to place an alliance building on top of him, like you do. And that was actually just me trying to snap teleport to the guy. But you see both C2 and Dizzle, like a pack of dogs, pow pow, hit one dragon. And we'll look at how these hits went. So, word of the wise, if you're not absolutely positive that you are ready to take a hit, then you should probably not port into three invaders. This guy found that out the hard way. He takes C2's hit pretty well, which we'll show in just a second. And you see me laughing at Dizzle and C2 hitting this guy. He actually shielded before I even got a hit on him. They just snapped off those solos so quickly I didn't get a time to do it. But let's look at C2's report here in just a second and see. He was about 900 million power whenever this started, and he dropped quite a bit there. Well, actually, not quite a bit. He took C2's hit really well. But for the most part, you don't want to do this right here. So you see C2 soloed him, only killed 500k, injured 2.5 million or so, and this guy took that hit like a champ. And he has 1400 infantry attack. That's what I was looking at the report for. I wanted to see in case he dropped a shield again. But you see here C2 sent tier 4, majority tier 4. And that is why this guy did it so well, because he had 7 million tier 5 infantry. He's got some random troops from of other tiers and everything like that, 450k siege and stuff like that. But the big thing is, this guy had 7 million tier 5 infantry. 7 million, which completely blocked C2's tier 4. That's why C2 hit him so softly. No offense, C2. But if you send tier 4 at somebody and they're even remotely prepared, you're not going to get any kills. Here's Dizzle's hit. He killed half his troops. 7.5 million. Same gear on the guy, 1400% infantry attack. And Dizzle sent all tier 5 and tier 6. And you see there, 7.5 million tier 5. Dizzle got all the way up into his tier 5. And ironically, C2 sent archers. Dizzle sent infantry. So this guy's an infantry-stacked target. He should get hit harder by C2's archers. But because of the fact that C2 sent Tier 4, and he had so many Tier 5, the defender had so many Tier 5, C2 didn't really do shit for damage to him. Dizzle crushed him because he sent all Tier 5 and Tier 6. And even though Dizzle sent infantry. So that shows you the power of those defending troops and the higher tiers defending, and it also shows why tier 6 attacks are so important, because tier 6 can't be defended against like that. Tier 4, the tier 5 defend against it. If you send tier 5, their tier 6 defend against it, and it reduces damage at a rapid rate, like even more rapid than gear and research and everything else. So now you see death by red here. I go in, I check all my buffs. He wanted me to solo him. I am not in the practice of just tossing troops into a wood chipper for absolutely no reason. I do it pretty frequently, but I usually like to rally on targets his size. So I set a rally, and let's go and see how it went. See, that's a rally. Wasn't all the way full, but I killed about 11.5 million troops, 3.5 million wounded, so about 15 million total out of 40 million. You see, he's got 816% troop attack, 364% troop HP. That tells me he's wearing Dark Lord. I sent archers because I thought he was a single type trap. A lot of these mid 3 billion guys are single types. He wasn't, though. He was wearing Dark Lord. And you see, I got all the way up into his tier 4 troops. So he had 11 million of each tier 4, and he had about 8 million tier 2 siege. So I killed all of his tier 2 siege, and then I got into his tier 4 troops after that. And so that shows you another thing from the previous combat testing that we've done. You want to make sure that your bottom tier has a ton of troops in it, because the only troop counts that matter to reduce the damage done to you are your bottom tier of troops, so usually tier 2, if you're running tier 2, and the tier of troops that are above the attacker troops. So since I sent tier 5, tier 6 right there, the only way he would have been able to use troop tiers to defend against that would have been to have tier 6. And you see me saying, I thought you'd be infantry. So if he had tier 6, they would have blocked the damage from my tier 5. Dizzle soloed him right after my rally landed and hit him nearly as hard. So you see here, I am telling Dizzle how I felt about that. So I hit the guy, killed 8 million of his tier 2 siege, and cleared all of them, and then got up into his tier 4, where he had about 33 million tier 4 troops. And you see Dizzle hit him right after that happened, and killed 9 million of those tier 4 troops, so a whole lot more power destroyed and everything like that. Same gear, Dizzle's running 2200% attack, so he is hitting harder than me. And he sent infantry, and let's look at how his infantry did against these tier 4. So he killed 6.4 million of the guy's cav. He only killed about 1.5 million of the infantry, and he killed 600k of the ranged, or the archers. So that shows you how powerful that leverage is. Because I cleared out the tier 2 siege, Dizzle was able to hit him using all infantry, and that leverage just crushed his cav. And that's why Dizzle hit the guy so hard, because he was wearing split defense gear. He wasn't stacked defense of any type. He had about 380% of it. So decent Dark Lord, not terrible. And then Dizzle's infantry were just fully leveraged into that cav, and that's why you hit him so damn hard. And that's what I'm getting at. If you're going to have a meat shield, you need to have a big meat shield. It needs to be big. And that's why you see in our trap setup articles and everything else like that, I recommend a massive amount of tier 2 and then a whole bunch of tier 5 and tier 6 if you can afford it. You definitely want to have enough tier 5 to block tier 4 attacks. And the more tier 6 you can build, the less damage tier 5 are going to do to you, so that's even better. There's nothing you can do about tier 6 other than stack a whole shitload of tier 2 troops. And this is a rally that we sent on this Nemu guy, who's a lot bigger. And so we rally him. Dizzle hits him for about 15 million troops or so out of 60 million, so about a quarter of his troops. But look at his gear. He's down here, 786% troop attack, 382% troop defense. That means he is wearing Dark Lord gear, so we know what to expect whenever we go look at the report. But he actually wasn't a full siege stack. We had some tier 4 in the battle as well. Our tier 5 got kills. Tier 4 got no kills there. Once again, like I was just talking about, no kills from the tier 4. This guy was running tier 3 troops. And you see he had tier 3 split troops. We killed the majority of his siege. And then we got into the other types of troops based exactly on how you would think we would have been able to get into them on the leverage. You see me, I am saying this. I skipped a little bit of the video there because it was pretty boring of us just looking for targets. And I said, I think this guy's not ready. Let's hit him, let's hit him, let's hit him, even though he's kind of big. He was ready-ish. And we did that much damage with the 4 million troop march to him. So that was all tier 3 kills, a little bit more power destroyed, and a little bit less kills because they have higher HP, so they're harder to kill. But they do give more power, so it's easier to burn somebody that is full tier 3 if they don't have a massive troop count, or tier 4 or tier 5. And so as I was getting at earlier, when we showed the difference between the Dizzle and the Come to Get You hits, and my hits earlier as well with tier 6, is that the only tier that matters when you are defending is your bottom tier of troops and the tier 1 above them. So at this point in the game, you need to anticipate people sending all tier 5 and tier 6 troops. That means your only tiers that are going to matter are your tier 2 troops and your tier 6 troops. You should have tier 5. You should build enough tier 5 in order to defend against tier 4s and just kind of treat that like a buffer. That needs to be there, and also then you can fill rallies as well. But what you need to focus on is you need to focus on that tier 2 stack, and your tier 2 stack needs to be massive because that troop count, as it increases, will decrease the damage taken. It has a direct correlation to the amount of damage that you take. The number of tier 2 troops you have standing in front will slowly reduce the amount of damage that attackers do. It takes a whole shitload of them, but it happens. And that's why if you look at my base, I've got 125 million tier 2 siege, and I'm still building them. And whenever I'm not building tier 6 now, I'm building tier 6 as much as I can because I want to block those tier 5. Tier 4 can't touch me. And as you saw on a lot of these targets, tier 4 couldn't touch them either. But tier 5 and tier 6 blew them up. So, give me a like, give me a follow. Kingdom 18, it was a whole lot of fun. Bizzle, C2, you guys hit like trucks as always. Zoot and Recip and Dusha and everybody else, thanks for showing up. My line ID is in the description if you'd like an invite to a channel. And maybe we'll see you in your kingdom next weekend.